Welcome back to another video, guys, and welcome back to the channel. As you can all see, we're going to have a lovely meeting today with all these lovely manufacturers. Well, between Launch and iCarsoft. Reality is this is no sponsor, this is nothing. This is just the reality of which diagnostic machine is the best and which one we should go for, depending on what your figure is in terms of your budget and, in other words, what is it capable of and what do you need from it. I'm going to eliminate these two for now. These are your still top two good stuff, but I am going to let them two go. And we're going to talk about the two over here, which the one on the left, I am going to open the box and go through it. So we have the iCarsoft CR Ultra P, which has just come out. It's like new and it is pretty damn good. Very good, should we say. And then the one on the right is the Launch X431 Pro3 ACE. Again, a brilliant piece of machine. We all know Launch has been out for years and years, and we are gonna open it up and look at it and take things from there. So here we are, guys. This is the box is opened with both tools on. As you can see, this one looks more advanced, and that is also the J2534, if I'm not mistaken. It is pretty solid. I'm going to go through everything, but this is just a quick glance. So as you can see, we've got these OBDs, BM and Merck, we've got these others, and we've got the battery tester, which slots into the back of this. This is a lovely piece of machine, guys. I have to say, it's incredibly built. Cannot fault it. Here we are, we have this here. I take it, it's the Type-C and the USB version. Underneath, nothing much, and I love this. Oh my god, manufacturers need to come out with this sort of design because it just hooks onto your steering wheel. That one has it as well, guys, so don't be fooled. And you've got a lot of different cabling, which you guys can look into it on the link as well for yourself. There's a lot, a ton of different OBDs as well. Now, that's that one, that's the iCarsoft. This is the Launch. Okay, the Launch comes with two boxes. I don't have the other box, but this is the image of what it actually looks like. This is the other box. You get two. What they've done here is they've made it very simple for Launch. They've just said, here you are, one box, so it's not heavy to carry around. And then the other OBD box, chuck it elsewhere. Whenever you need it, you use it. Whereas this one, they've built everything in case you do need to use it. But I'm going to leave that debate between you all. I know Autel does the same thing as well. So Autel will do very similar things in terms of the box size. They put all the OBDs in and then it's for you to judge. But they are heavy, I'm not going to lie, but it's there if you ever want to use it. Whereas this one, like we said, you get the basic thing, OBD dongle. And here you are. This is the machine. So we're just going to look around it and we're going to go through everything in a second as well. Camera just like the other one. And you've got this backstand, which is brilliant. And they're both touch screen as well. So here they are, side by side again, guys. So the iCarsoft is on the right and the Launch is on the left, as we can see. So both tools are built for serious diagnostic work in workshop and garages. But the question is, which one offers more value, better features and a long-term use? Let's kind of break it all down. So we're going to start with the iCarsoft and the key strength of the iCarsoft CR Ultra P. So we're going to go through it, like, in terms of, we'll do that bullet point, see if that makes sense. So it's a modern, okay, high-end scanner designed for in-depth diagnostics. It's a large 10.1 inch HD touchscreen, as we said earlier, and it's very clear and very responsive. Let's make that straight. The iCarsoft also offers 12,600 mAh battery, a massive capacity, and can last roughly 20 hours, maybe over 20 hours, depending on how you use it and what brightness you use. It has a 4GB RAM and 128GB internal storage. Fast and spacious, guys. Here it is. The CR Link VCI supports the latest protocols, J2534, as we said earlier, the DOIP, CAN-FD, DPDU, RP1210, and it does bi-directional controls, tests, and activates components. It does also, online coding and programming supports 13 plus major brands, so such as BMW, Audi, Porsche, you know, all the VAG cars. Also includes 41 hot reset functions. I'll break it down as well, so some of them, not all of them. You've got like oil, DPF, immobilizer, BMS, knock sensor, add blue, throttle, clutch, injector coding, you name it, guys. It does literally everything you can ask for. And then you've got the topology mapping as well, a visual overview of the vehicle's ECU. Again, the launch will do the same in that sense. It will have a topology mapping. You've got that kind of tree route, shall we say. It comes with a built-in battery test module, which I had shown you earlier. You just slot onto the back. It includes the OBDI adapters for older vehicles, which both do. The iCarsoft comes with 3 years of free software update. So the minute you buy it, you get 3 years free update, okay? So that's for the iCarsoft and for the launch, guys. So the key strength of the Launch X431 Pro 3 ACE. So it's a workshop grade scan tool trusted by many garages because it's been out for years. Same as the iCarsoft, but it's been a longer time the launch has been launched. It does a full system diagnostic scan for almost all brands, just like the iCarsoft. It does the European, American, Asian, Chinese vehicles. Again, same as the iCarsoft. Bi-directional control for real-time testing, it does that. So online ECU coding, programming for VW, Audi, Mercedes, BMW, and so on and so on. It also does immobilizer key programming. It adds, resets, and deletes keys for the launch. So it's a good stuff for anyone in the key game. It supports the ADAS calibration with optional hardware, okay? Expandable with add-ons as well, so like the TPMS, tire pressure monitor sensor tools, the camera and the printer and whatnot. Again, this is also a 10.1-inch Android tablet with a fast 8-core processor. So they are both pretty smooth, not gonna lie, and they're both 10.1-inch. They are literally like for like. You cannot get something equivalent to these two in this game. The other thing is it has 6,300 mAh battery, which can last around about 12 to 15 hours per charge. Comes in two boxes, as we said earlier, one for the tablet and one for the OBD1 adapters. And finally, it comes with 2 years free update. That one comes with three, that one's two. So we're kind of getting sense of, you know, what that one has and what this one has. We're going to move on to what they have in common, so you can all be aware of, you know, if I'm buying that one, what does that one have and what does this one have. So they both do a full system diagnostic scan, so it goes through the engine, gearbox, airbag, ABS, body system, you name it, it does all the full scan of the car. They both have bi-directional control, activates windows, injectors, fans, etc. They both do online coding and ECU programming, it depends which brand it is, really. They're both Android tablet format, okay, familiar and easy to use. Again, like I said, they are both 10.1-inch touchscreens, great visuals and multitasking, so they're both pretty smooth, to be fair. I've used them both and can't fault them in that sense. They're both there. They both do the same job. They both have the topology mapping in for full ECU layout view, work with modern protocols, J2534, DOAP, and CAN-FD. And you've got the service functions like oil reset, BMS, DPF, throttle, steering angle sensor. You've got many other features on there, which I'll kind of go through it as well, so you know what's what. And should we say compatible with both OBDI and the OBD2, should we say, vehicles. Both can work with external accessories and expand functions. So okay, before I move any further, I'm just going to show you. So this is the service function on the iCarsoft, as we can see. It kind of shows you in this sort of format. It has everything you can ask for. You've got like the DPF, tire pressure monitor, whatnot, airfield. And this is the launch. It brings up in this sort of format. Again, knock sensor. They are really like identical. And bizarrely, they both have window calibration on the very last page, on the last button. But yeah, you can already see, guys, and know what it's capable of in that sense. So, on to one of the final conclusions, shall we say. This is the key differences to know, okay? this is the difference between these two. This is a way of for you guys to make a judgment and to kind of, I want you to comment as well to tell me which one's better after this. So the battery life, the CR Ultra P has a 12,600 mAh battery. This is a 20 plus hour. The X431 Pro3 ACE has 6,300 mAh battery, which lasts about 12 hours. I'll leave that for you to decide which is a winner, I guess the iCarsoft is. The VCI module, CR Ultra P, includes a more advanced VCI as standard CR Link. Okay, Launch uses the DBS SCAR VCI solid, but less protocol support without upgrades. So you kind of get the bonus on that one rather than the Launch. You've got the battery tester. Only the CR Ultra P includes this feature out of the box, which I can't really comment. You saw it in the box there. Software updates. So the CR Ultra P offers 3 years free update. So after 3 years, then you're gonna have to, you know, pay the yearly subscription. Whereas the Launch gives you 2 years free update. You've got storage and speed, okay? So the CR Ultra P has 128 gigabyte ROM. A Launch Pro 3 ACE typically has 64 gigabyte ROM. Now you can already see, again, the winner is the iCarsoft. And the immobilizer and the ADAS features. Launch has stronger key programming and ADAS calibration support, ideal for locksmith and advanced repair shops. So winner winner on this side, on the left, eh? If we move on to the accessory support, okay, Launch supports a wider range of branded add-ons, TPMS, scope, printer, whereas the iCarsoft doesn't, okay. Upfront cost, Launch is usually more affordable. Yep, very true. And iCarsoft includes more extras like battery testers and better VCIs. So I want you to make this decision. I don't want you to think, oh, I'm not going to make the decision for you, but you can see this gives you a lot of features, but it's more dear. This gives you less, it's cheaper. So you need to work out, are you a garage? Do you want every box ticked? Okay, are you just trying to do a bit, one or two cars here and just want to, I don't know, not go crazy, I guess. But then again, they're both like high-end stuff, so don't be fooled. So like moving on. So moving on to the pricing and software renewal cost, okay? The iCarsoft CR Ultra P, this one here is around about £1,200 to £1,450 in the UK. 3 years free update. After that, for the renewal yearly subscription, it's about £200 to £300 a year to update. Yep, so that's how much the cost is to update. Again, moving on to the Launch. The Launch X431 Pro 3 ACE is around about £1,000. Anywhere between £900 to £1,100, depending on, again, it all depend on what the offers are, what offers they have on, but that's the sort of figure you'd be looking at in the UK. So, and you get 2 years free update. The renewal after that is about £300, £350 a year for the update, for the subscription. Now remember one thing, guys, we just said this one comes with 3 years, and it the rough price is about £1,200. This is roughly a grand, okay? Just a year's update, you get more. So you're saving yourself roughly £100 by getting this, and you've got the 3 year update. If you were to get 3 year update with that, you'd be looking at about £1,300, roughly. So you see? Well, here we are. I mean, the final verdict, which one should you get? I mean, that's the question we're gonna ask ourselves here. I mean, the iCarsoft CR Ultra P is a powerhouse, big battery, advanced VCI battery tester, and a generous 3 years update. Great for all round workshop use, even mobile mechanics. I mean, mobile mechanics is a number one, okay? Because you've got a hell load of battery time. I hate it when you have to come home every night, charge up, charge up, charge up. Yeah, so, you know, we've got to understand, even when you go on a DPF regen, there's the time consuming, because you might be out for an hour or two doing this DPF regen, or maybe even coding injectors, I don't know, doing live data on certain modules. It's just so annoying having to recharge. So it's a bonus on this side, guys, it really is. I mean, the Launch X431 Pro 3 ACE is a well-proven all-rounder with stronger immobilizer and ADAS and accessory supports. It's ideal for busy shops that handle key coding and more technical repairs. I mean, there we are, guys. It really is something for you guys to judge. I can see which is more powerful. I can see which is more capable in terms of in the mechanic world, but I'd like to hear your feedback. Let me drop a comment below to tell us which one you choose anyway, and don't forget to like and subscribe and hit the bell for more real world diagnostic reviews, guys. But thank you very much for tuning in, and I'll hopefully see you on another video.